Hello guys and welcome to Draco Ray Gaming. Today we're going to be talking about Cyberpunk 2077 FPS. We're going to set up the best settings we possibly can. As usual, no BS, no fluff. Here we go. Here we are inside Cyberpunk. Cyberpunk 2077 is finally here, and after years and years and millions of people waiting all over the world, we are rather disappointed a little bit with the performance. It is poorly optimized. This is not like CD Projekt Red. It's got multiple issues, unfortunately, across all platforms and computer. Luckily, on PC, we have some options and some settings we can adjust to try to get the best FPS possible while maintaining some quality. Now, as usual, I don't want to waste any of your time, but please, guys, make sure you take care of the basics. Run the game as admin. Update your graphics drivers and your Windows updates. So if you don't know how to actually run Cyberpunk as admin, go to your computer, go to the drive that it's on. I actually have it on the D drive. Go to your Steam library, Steam apps, common, go to Cyberpunk 2077 folder, bin folder, x64. There you will find the 62 meg Cyberpunk exe. You want to go to properties, compatibility, run this program as admin, check the box, hit apply, and okay. Now, if you ever, during any of my Fixit videos, have any problems saying any files and or folders, make sure you type hidden files and folders, click show hidden files and folders, click OK, make sure that's turned on so you can see everything. Now, if you don't know how to do Windows updates, throw your computer out the window, update your Windows, and update your graphics drivers in the G4 experience right down here. Okay, now that we got all that out of the way, let's get down to the nitty gritty. Let's get down to the settings. Now, it seems that there's some presets here. So you got low, medium, high, ultra, ray tracing medium, ray tracing ultra. I would highly recommend not using the ray tracing in this game currently, as I don't believe it's working, and I got some game crashes out of it. So even with the new updated driver, there were some game crashes that I was getting, so not awesome. I'm gonna tell you right off the bat, so I don't waste your time. Some of the biggest things that make the difference in frames on this game are DLSS. Cascaded shadow resolution and depth of field, motion blur. These are the settings. These are the 3 to 4 settings that make the biggest difference. So if you're impatient like most people are, those are the 4 things that are gonna help you out with this. But if you wanna stay tuned, please do, because I got some more information for you. So I didn't notice a difference no matter what I did on the presets, if I did low, medium, or high settings, honestly. I adjusted the field of view as well, and normally when you go a high field of view, you'll notice a frame per second dip. I didn't notice any. I like running a high FOV just for preference, so that's your preference as well. I can see more, I got an ultra wide, I got a curved screen, so I just like it. Okay, now, I would recommend going starting on high or medium, depending on your PC settings or your PC hardware. I have pretty decent PC specs, so I'm gonna go ahead and put this on high. Let's start there as a playing field. I went field of view 100. Film grain, we're gonna turn it off. Chromatic aberration, off. Depth of field, off. Motion blur, off, okay? All this adds a bunch of pressure on your system and takes up resources without actually making the game look any better. Motion blur is also a preference for you. I think it's garbage. I don't like it. I don't like my screen getting all blurry when I'm playing. I like to like have a nice clear seeing field. So I'm gonna go film grain off, chromatic aberration off, which just simulates reflection of light. Depth of field causes distant objects to become unfocused and causes just extra hardware resource. Like I said, I don't really care about that. Lens flare, so simulates the scattering of light with the lens and, you know, causes these things. Now, if you like that, cool. If not, I mean, honestly, you could turn it off to save some more hardware resources, and then motion blur off. Now, contact shadows. The shadows have a big performance decreaser in this game when they're turned on, particularly the cascaded ones. So contact shadows I'm going to leave off. The lighting geometry is fine. Typically when you're up close with people, it's not like really in the city. It's more like in dark rooms and inside environments where it's not gonna affect FPS too much. You can leave that on. The anisotropy, you can leave that on 8. If you put it up really high, it's gonna get a little crazy. And I'll show you another trick where you can actually turn this off and then use the NVIDIA control panel and use image sharpening to improve the quality rather than these kind of settings, which could be another thing you can try. Local shadow mesh quality, we can leave medium. Shadow quality overall for local, you can leave medium. Cascaded shadow range, this is where I'm just gonna turn this guy's on low, and this makes one of the biggest differences on the game, I'm telling you, is the cascaded shadows, cascaded shadow resolution, depth of field, DLSS to performance, setting that performance helps as well. Distant shadow resolution, I mean, I'm gonna go low on that as well. All shadows, I'm gonna go low. Now, the fog resolution, the cloud quality, you can leave on high, medium, I didn't notice a difference. The dynamic decals, and also the reflections, I did not notice much of a performance decrease or increase, and leaving them on leaves the game looking a little bit better, so it's up to you. Medium or high, I would recommend for all these settings here. Ambient occlusion, I'm gonna leave on medium. Color precision's on high. Didn't notice an FPS difference on that as well. Like I said, DLS performance, depth of field, cascaded shadows, motion blur, film grain, things like that are what making an FPS difference in this game. Now, because I'm trying to get you the maximum FPS while also maintaining game quality. And that's what, because you don't want to ruin your experience by just turning everything off. Anybody can do that. So I've found and spent time fine-tuning these settings to make sure that the game looks good and you're getting a decent frame per second. So level of detail I also left on high, and mirror quality on medium. Mirror quality left high can have some FPS decrease. So right now DLS is turned off by default. So what I actually want to do is turn it to performance. Now, I want to show you what the game looks like on off, and we're gonna leave fidelity and static fidelity off, ray tracing off. Okay, got it. Good. We're gonna back out of here. I'm gonna show you the game. Okay, we're looking pretty good. We're getting almost 60 frames here with decent image quality in the city with DLSS off. I want to show you what DLSS does. Now, you're getting good image quality and good frames with the settings that I just gave you, but what you're actually gonna do here, if you need more frames per second, if you don't have the hardware to really play this game because it's not optimized right now, is turn DLSS to performance. And that's, we're gonna notice a little bit of a quality drop, but not much. And I honestly am not getting more frames right now with it on. Maybe a bit more. I'm hitting like almost 60 in some areas because it's a very graphic intense area, but you can see it still looks good and it may help your system out with FPS as well. And I'm able to play at almost 60 frames in high quality. So you can also set this to ultra performance. I wouldn't recommend it because you're going to see a big kind of blurry performance drop. And I don't know if you can tell, but it definitely got more fuzzy with the DLSS. The DLSS can do a big difference. So once you get the shadows taken care of, the motion blur, the film grain, the depth of field, and the cascaded shadows, like I said, the big thing is DLSS options here. They actually work in the game to get you some performance in FPS. So this is a big one down here. So make sure you check it out. So I'm gonna leave this. So this is kind of my recommended settings right now. They're custom. Field of view's preference, film grain off, chromatic aberration off, depth of field off, lens flare on, motion blur off, contact shadows off, facial geometry on. We're going medium, mesh quality, local shadow quality medium, cascaded shadow range and shadow resolution low, distant shadow resolution low. So basically all shadows low. Fog, clouds, decals, space reflection, scattering. Honestly, you can leave all this stuff on high. The only thing that might make a difference here, throwing it to mediums, mirror quality and ambient occlusion. Ray tracing off, DLSS to performance, fidelity casts, and static and dynamic fidelity casts is on off. And these are the absolute best settings I can recommend for getting good frames. I'm playing in 2K right now, and I'm getting really decent frames for being in one of the most stressful kind of points of the city with lights and moving kind of things going around and cars and people and fog and smoke coming out of the sewers. So these are the absolute best settings I found for frames per second in all my testing. I hope this helps you out. This is working for my system. I'm Draco Ray Gaming. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell for when I go live and do live streams. And I look forward to playing games with you guys, and I'll catch you next time.